Today I chose a topic that is close to my heart. It is about finding who you are and your place in the world. A long time ago, I was going through this process, and as I work with clients, I see many of them struggling with the same type of issues. The ideas that will be presented today simply have helped me on my journey. I grew up in the Ukraine. I was raised as an atheist. Religion was forbidden in our society at that time. I think we had one church and one synagogue in our city, and practically no one ever went there. People were afraid to go since it was against the doctrines of the Communist Party, and they could have lost their job or there might have been other negative consequences. In my 17 years living there, I was inside the religious establishment once in my life. It was a part of a tour on one of my trips. The guide talked about the architecture of the building, totally avoiding anything related to religion. As the time went by, I took experimental psychology class during my studies at Oglethorpe University in Atlanta. As a part of this class, we had to do a study or experiment. I was working at the time with Russian and American elderly. So the topic of my study was the fear of death among Russian and American elderly. I had a questionnaire with 20 questions that was given to both of these groups. Even before I had a chance to do statistical analysis on them, I had observed significant difference in reaction to the topic of the questionnaire. As I was given the instructions to the people about what needed to be done, American people listened calmly, filled out the questionnaires, and returned them to me once they were done. Afterwards, they returned to their normal activities. Russian people, who were mostly raised in atheists, had a very different reaction. Some of them, after receiving the questionnaire, glanced over it, tore it, and threw it into the trash. Some had negative comments about it, and some didn't, but were rather unhappy. Later on, I worked as a chaplain at the hospital. I had many patients dealing with serious illnesses, death and dying related to themselves or their loved ones. I noticed that when people came from strong spiritual and religious backgrounds, they had a lot easier time dealing with these issues. So, what is life? What is death? Why are we here? Who are we? These are the questions we are going to explore right now. There used to be a wonderful healer and teacher in Georgia, Reverend Joanne Marney. I was one of her students. As I was studying with her, these were the first few questions we had to tackle before proceeding anywhere else. I call this ABCs of life, because your answer to them will lay a foundation for your life and what you do with it. The first idea I would like to introduce is that there is one creator, and his power is unconditional love. It doesn't matter what your religion is and the name you give to the creator. The concept in itself is that there is one creative force that created everything that ever existed. That all things that are created didn't appear randomly. That there are universal laws and orders that govern all things. We may not always know and understand these laws or connections and interplay between different things in the universe, but nevertheless, they are there. The power of that creator is unconditional love. This is the strongest, most powerful force that exists in the universe. The power opposite to love is fear. Yes, we live in the world of duality, the world of opposites. We have life and death, white and black, love and fear, good and evil. We were all given a gift of free will. That means that at every moment in time, we make a choice to feed love or fear in our life, to be on the side of good or evil. Every thought that we have, every word that we say, every act that we do puts us either on the side of good or evil. I used to see it as a person walking a straight line. On both sides of that line are two semicircles that meet on that line. One side is domain of good and another is domain of evil. And in the middle you are. At each moment of our existence, we take a step toward good, evil, or stay in the middle. Each choice that we make will have some consequence. When you spend your life on the side of good, the consequences will be positive. If you stay more on the darker side, your life will mirror that. You are creating the events in your life with every choice that you make. We are all given an ability to co-create. No matter what your life looks like right now, you can always make changes in it to better your situation. Sometimes we may simply need some assistance or guidance to see where we are coming from and where we are going to start making desired changes. It is never too late to change things in your life. The second idea I would like to introduce is that this life is a school for our spirit. What does it mean? It means that we came here to learn certain lessons. We are born specifically at this time, in the specific country, city, as a particular family, facing our particular circumstances, so we can experience what we need in order to learn our lessons. Once we learn our lessons, we can move forward, meaning it is time to go back where we came from, and where that might be. Reverend Marnie used to say, "Imagine that Creator is the sun, and each one of us is one ray of the sun. We are part of the Creator, and Creator is part of us." We call this part spirit. In making of the baby, there are three participants: mom and dad, who create the physical body, and Creator provides the life for that body, which is our spirit. The simplest model of a person is a triangle with three corners: body, mind, and spirit. So the spirit comes into this world carrying in itself information about the lessons we have to learn and the missions we came to accomplish. Once we learn the lessons and accomplished our mission, our spirit goes back home. This is what we call death. Death is simply change from physical form to non-physical form. Our bodies go into the ground, but our essence, who we truly are, remains forever and part of a greater being. Death is nothing more than a transition from one state of being to another. A lot of people have fears and misconceptions related to death. Maybe it is one of those topics we don't often talk about in our families. As children, we may see all the pain our family members go through losing someone close to them, and maybe we went through something like that ourselves. Yet life and death are two sides of one coin. Let me ask you something. When you went to school, did you want to graduate? Sure you did, and you wanted to move on with your life to bigger things. The same thing is with death. You went to school of life, you learned your lessons, you accomplished your mission, and you're ready to graduate. So you move on to do other things. It doesn't matter how old you are. It may be a young child who came to learn just one particular lesson and was ready to move on. It could be a teenager who came here for a short while to learn a few things and move on. Or a young woman who gave birth to a child and her mission was done. It may be hard for us to understand or accept such losses. Yet it was time for them to graduate, and our job is to wish them well on their new journey. When we are constantly thinking about someone who died and experience a lot of grief and prolonged periods of negative emotions and regrets, we don't allow our loved ones to move forward in their new life. We are causing a lot of pain to them and to ourselves. It is a lot healthier for them and for us to let them go forward and let ourselves move forward. Every time you think of them, thank them for the time they were here with you, for the wonderful moments you have shared, and wish them happiness and all the best on their new journey. Remember all the good, forgive if you need to, and embrace your new journey as well. Yes, your life will change without them being in it. It is your new journey and your new beginning as well. Perhaps you will meet again one day. I would like to read to you one poem written by James Freeman in 1947 called "I'm There." By the way, this poem went to the moon with Colonel James Irwin on Apollo 15. Irwin left a microfilm copy of the poem on the moon. Do you need me? I'm there. You cannot see me, yet I'm the light you see by. You cannot hear me, yet I speak through your voice. You cannot feel me, yet I'm the power at work in your hands. I am at work, so you do not understand my ways. I am at work, so you do not understand my works. I am not strange visions. I am not mysteries. Only in absolute stillness beyond self can you know me as I am, and then but as a feeling and a face. Yet I am there. Yet I hear. Yet I answer. When you need me, I am there. Even if you deny me, I am there. Even when you feel most alone, I am there. Even in your fears, I am there. Even in your pain, I am there. I am where you, when you pray and when you do not pray. I am in you and you are in me. Only in your mind can you feel separate from me, for only in your mind there are mists of yours and mine. Yet only with your mind can you know me and experience me. Empty your heart of empty fears. When you get yourself out of the way, I am there. You can of yourself do nothing, but I can do all. I am in all. So you may not see the good, good is there, for I am there. I am there because I have to be, because I am. Only in me does the world have meaning. Only out of me does the world take form. Only because of me does the world go forward. I am the law on which the movement of the stars and the growth of living cells are founded. I am the love that is the law's fulfilling. I am assurance. I am peace. I am oneness. I am the law that you can live by. I am the love that you can cling to. I am your assurance. I am your peace. I am one with you. I am. So you fail to find me, I do not fail you. So your faith in me is unsure. My faith in you never wavers, because I know you, because I love you. Beloved, I am there. I really like this poem and felt I wanted to share it with you tonight. I think so far we covered some basic ideas about ourselves and the world. Let's go briefly over them. Who are we? We are spirits living in a human body, having a human experience. What is life? It is a school for our spirit. Why are we here? To learn lessons and accomplish our mission, and to be co-creators. Is everything in our lives predetermined? Some things are. However, we have free will and make choices at every moment in time that shape our life. What is death? Transition from physical existence to non-physical existence, going back home to our Creator. One may ask, how can I come from a place of being an atheist to believe in power greater than myself? It is usually a journey. In my case, I had something bad happen many years ago, and I ended up on my knees talking to the thin air and asking for help if Creator existed. Within 3 days, things started to change in my life in a very significant way. Now, when I look back, it was as if I was led by an invisible hand. Today, I simply shared with you a set of questions and possible answers that I see many of my clients are looking for. This is just my view on the specific topic. Thank you for joining me tonight. Feel free to call me or email me if you have additional questions. I would like to make an appointment. If you're on a personal growth journey or struggling with death and dying or dealing with physical, emotional, situational, or spiritual challenges, I will be happy to assist you. Have a wonderful evening, everybody.